Welcome friends. Now we are going to know the equation for the progressive wave before getting the equation for the stationary wave. Very simple concept. Here I am going to consider the wave which is progressing continuously in a given direction. Let us consider this direction is x. The wave which is continuously traveling along x-axis. So it is traveling along a positive x-axis. So its displacement equation it is given by y is equal to a sine of omega t minus phi. This is the equation. What about the omega t plus phi? This represents the phase of the equation, total phase. Whereas this factor phi represent the initial phase of the wave. Initial phase of the wave. What is mean by this initial phase? When the wave starts from this point zero, reference point zero, from the origin we say, at that place, I am going to consider the particle which is starting from the first position is nothing but the initial phase, that is phi. But this position changes every when the wave starts. It will never start from zero. It may start from 90 degree out of phase. It may start from 180 degree out of phase. Okay, I will show you that if the wave starts from zero, it is just like this. Means it is starting from 0 degree. If it starts from 90, that time I am going to show the wave. Means the initial phase of the wave is 90 degree. That time its phi value is 90. In this wave diagram, the phi value is 0. If it is just like this, means both are opposite to each other, 0 means obviously it is 180 degree or pi radian. Means initial phase of the wave is how much? 180 degree or pi radian. Means this represent the initial phase, whereas omega t plus phi represent the total phase of the wave which is traveling continuously in a given direction. Sir, possibly what happened when this wave traveling from positive to negative direction, then what happened to this equation? Just instead of this minus, it becomes plus. It became plus. Means when it is traveling along positive direction, this equation is negative. If it is traveling along the negative x direction, that time equation is y is equal to a sine of omega t plus phi. Once again, this is your total phase, this is your initial phase. When I am going to consider the total wave, its length any point P at a distance x, and at this position let I am going to count its phase phi. Here at this place I am going to count that phase. Now in this equation, one of the equation we are going to consider, let us consider it traveling along the positive x direction. So this equation I am going to utilize. So its equation is y is equal to a sine of omega, can be written as omega is equal to either 2 pi n or omega is equal to 2 pi upon t. We already saw this equation in rotational dynamics. So 2 pi upon t into small t. Sir, what is the difference between this capital T and small t? Here it is, capital T, small t. A time at that instance, let us consider the particle which is moving along the x-axis and it is continuously progressing. That time what happens? See, I will say stop at this instant. Now at this instant I will say stop at this instant, time is small t, but the complete time taken by the wave is a capital T. Okay, means a short time is a small t, and time taken by the variable capital T. So what about this phi? Sir, it is taken minus, means it is traveling along positive x axis. So 2 pi upon t into small t minus phi. Sir, how to get the value of phi? Yeah, very simple. Total distance traveled by the wave within a time period t is how much? Lambda. This is the wavelength. For that one, how much is the phase? 2 pi. Means very simple. For the 2 pi phase, the distance is lambda. Distance is lambda. So how much is the phase? Let us consider this phase is phi. For the phi, the distance is x. So what about the phi equation? Equal to 2 pi x upon lambda. This equation I am going to substitute. So this is a 2 pi x upon lambda. What is the common factor? The common factor is 2 pi, which is taken outside, 2 pi. Then in bracket, capital T, small t upon capital T minus x upon lambda. This is one form of the equation. Can be also be written as y is equal to a sine of 2 pi nt minus x upon lambda. So how it came? 1 by t is equal to n. This is your final equation of a progressive wave traveling along x axis. Once again, in very short, equation of the progressive wave: when the wave which is continuously traveling along x axis, its total phase for the one complete wave is a 2 pi. We can divide that into different segments, just like the 2 pi, half is pi, here it is pi by 2, here it is 3 pi by 2. So total phase is 2 pi, the length is lambda, seems to be imaginary point where I am going to calculate the phase. Let us consider its phase is phi at this place, at the point P, and distance I am going to consider as x. Along the positive direction, when the wave it is traveling along the positive x direction, y is equal to, displacement equation is y is equal to a sine of omega t minus phi. Phi represents initial phase, whereas omega t minus phi or a plus phi represents total phase. Sir, what is the difference? Once again, negative, positive. When the wave which is traveling along the positive x axis, the equation is omega t minus phi. It is traveling along the negative x axis, its equation is plus. Means y is equal to a sine of omega t plus phi. Now substituting all that values, omega is equal to either 2 pi n or 2 pi by t. After substituting, we are going to get the two different forms of the equation, which is a equation of the progressive wave. Hence, we will stop here. Thank you.